Well, folks, it's that time of year again. The Southwest Classic between the Arkansas Razorbacks and the Aggies of Texas A&M. And despite the fact that the Aggies have won 10 of the last 11 contests between these two teams, somehow this has proven to be one of the best and wildest games of the college football season over the last decade. And let the record show that despite the Aggies' recent success, the Razorbacks do hold the all-time series record with 42 wins to 34 losses. And with that said, this season's matchup has all the makings of being another classic between these two rivals. And with that little preview, let's dive right into it. Texas A&M coming into this game fresh off a victory at home against Auburn 27-10. Arkansas fresh off two consecutive losses to BYU and at LSU, both games in which they had ample opportunity to pull off the win. You should have a very desperate, very hungry Arkansas team coming into this game, as should A&M be as well, but I think there's a different level of urgency between the two. Regardless, though, this is undoubtedly a huge game for both teams in terms of what they want and can accomplish this season. The SEC West looks as wide open as we've seen it in quite some time. Objectively, this is a game that A&M could afford to drop, but if they're going to be a true contender to win the West title, this feels like a must-win for them. Conversely, Arkansas feels like it already has its shoulders pressed up against the wall. If they want to be the top-tier team that they believe this roster has the potential to be, they've absolutely got to find a way to get the job done this week and get back on the winning track. This is certainly going to be a great test and measuring stick for both teams. A&M will get its second real test against a truly talented offense and quarterback, and Arkansas will see a team very similar to the LSU team they just faced in Baton Rouge, arguably maybe even a bit more talented, minus obviously a Heisman contender in Jaden Daniels at quarterback. And speaking of quarterback, let's go ahead and talk about that. Obviously, unless you haven't already heard, A&M's starting quarterback Connor Wegman is out for the season. I pray he comes back better than ever. But that means Max Johnson is now the Aggies starter going forward. So let's talk a little bit about Max, because I don't think there's any doubt that quarterback play is going to be one of the biggest determining factors in this game. And I'll first start by saying that I don't really know what the consensus is around the country on this, how people feel about this, but I don't think this hurts A&M that badly. Obviously, Connor Wegman is a special talent. Obviously, there's a reason that he was starting, but there might not be a better backup in the country than Max Johnson, at least in terms of proven production. Max Johnson would start for a lot of other teams, the vast majority of teams across college football, even some teams in the SEC. So I don't think there's going to be any lack of confidence there from Jimbo or Bobby or the team in general. Obviously, like I already noted, he's not Jaden Daniels, but like Jaden Daniels, he has a lot of complementary talent around him. And defensively, I'd say the Aggies look even slightly better than LSU. The statistics certainly say they are. So what the Aggies might lack comparable to LSU offensively, they kind of somewhat make up for defensively. And Arkansas is a team that, despite that 2-2 start, despite the fact that the Aggies are perceivably a bit more talented than them overall, is still a team that absolutely has enough at its disposal, especially with KJ Jefferson at quarterback, to upset the Aggies just as they could have easily have done to LSU. Through 4 weeks of play, the biggest or at least the most glaring weakness for both of these teams is themselves. And what I mean by that is A&M ranks 110th in the country in penalties with 31 flags for 243 yards. Arkansas, not to be outdone, ranking 121st in the country with 36 flags for 314 yards. Penalties, turnovers, and efficiency in the red zone, meaning not only scoring when you get down there, but scoring touchdowns when you get down there, are going to be vital keys for both of these teams. Neither has an overwhelming talent or matchup advantage over the other overall. This should be a great game between two great teams that essentially comes down to nothing more than which executes at a higher level and earns the W. I mentioned penalties, whereas you heard, these two teams are pretty equally awful. When it comes to turnovers, however, the Razorbacks have forced 8 on the season, the Aggies just 2. The Razorbacks have a +4 turnover margin, the Aggies a -2. in terms of red zone efficiency. That's another area where these two teams are relatively equal. The Aggies reaching the red zone 21 times and converting 14 of those trips into touchdowns. The Razorbacks reaching the red zone 17 times and converting 13 of those into touchdowns. And another thing to note with turnovers is that both of these quarterbacks, Max Johnson and KJ Jefferson, do a great job of protecting the football. Over his career, Max Johnson has a 60% completion rate for 4,627 yards, 42 touchdowns, and only 7 interceptions. KJ Jefferson over his career has a 66% completion rate for 6,734 yards, 57 touchdowns, and 13 interceptions. So as we alluded to earlier, quarterback play is obviously going to be a huge determining factor in this game. I don't know that either has to necessarily light the world on fire, although it would help, but they have to be sure not to put their team in unfavorable positions, to not make that costly and untimely mistake that gives the opponent one extra opportunity to put you away. The current line, I believe, has A&M as a 5.5-point favorite in this game. I believe that's very fair. Per the norm, I don't think either team wins this game by more than 2 possessions. At the end of the day, although I do really like Max Johnson and think Bobby will still be able to get plenty of production out of him in this game and moving forward this season, I just foresee KJ making one or two more game-defining plays. So give me my Hogs in a close one. I like them to overcome the odds, to get back on track with a big win against a really good A&M team. And I wouldn't necessarily take that to the bank now, but I would certainly start prepping for another wild classic in Jerry's world. Well, folks, that's all for now. Thank y'all for y'all's time. Please let me know y'all's thoughts and opinions in the comments section. Until next time, I pray the Lord keeps you all safe and blessed. Thank y'all for all the love and support, especially you, Rabid Razorback family. And of course, go Hogs!